after I unpacked my stuff, my mum and dad left, and I was a bit nervous, but loads of people were coming in and just sitting in the kitchen and chatting, and we just got talking straight away.
We make sure with every single person coming along, we all have the same question maybe 200 times, but it's taking that question like you've heard it the first time.
The crack over here is brilliant compared to anywhere else that I've been. You make friends and the community spirit brings everyone into one place.
We never let a student walk past without saying hello. This is their home, this is where they live, and it's a small community together.
It is really like a little village.
Because you've got the central hub being the Treehouse, you know, is in a way it's a reference point, but with all the services being in there, you know, you've got a small shop if you need it. You've got the use of a computer space and also a work area down there as well as the laundry.
The study space we have, it's for all Queen's students. Students can come on before 11 o'clock.
The support network here is brilliant. The residential assistants and the life coordinators are really useful.
When they come through the doors, want to be the first point of contact. They make them feel welcome. They can feel like it's a home away from home. We're here and we'll direct them to the right people. If we don't have the answer, we'll find someone that does have the answer.
They'll have like pizza nights or film nights and stuff like that. So that's really good to go to get talking to more people.
It's about, what, a 15-minute walk or so from campus. Yeah. You have Tesco just up the road on the Lisbon Road, and that's a 10-15-minute walk again. Pretty decent bus links to get from here down into town. I think where we are is perfect for, you know, being far enough away from university that you don't feel like you're always there, but as well, you're close enough that if you have to run in down to the library because you've got some last-minute work to do, obviously I don't condone that, we definitely get all our work done on time.
After 11 p.m, they didn't let anyone in who doesn't have a student card or a room key or hasn't been checked in as a guest.
You feel safe within your own flat, knowing that no one else can get in. And then the same with the block, you have to have a key that gets you into your own block.
It does feel really safe. It's just a really friendly city to be in, and people are always smiling and looking happy.
I've been to other friends' universities, and it definitely feels the safest and the friendliest of university cities.
I think I'm a lot more independent than I thought I was going to be, because when my parents first left me here, I was freaking out a little bit, but being able to walk everywhere and just getting to know people and getting to know myself a bit more, I just realised how independent I actually am.
For me, coming to Queen's was about me being my own person and not being Alexander from that school, but being Alexander who's just from England.
It's a great site. There's over 2,000 students you can meet within accommodation at Queen's. So make a friendly face, you could make a friend for life.
Make sure you put yourself out there, and if people are sat in the kitchen, go in there and have a chat to them, because they will be friendly and they will be nice to you because they're in exactly the same position as you.
You build friendship groups in different areas. Don't just build them up in Elms, build them up in your sport, in your club, in your society. Build up as many different circle of friends as you can, and you know, you'll have a brilliant time at Queen's.